Hey friends, welcome to Christy Reacts and thanks for being here. If you're new here, I'm Christy and here's where we watch all the shows and movies that you recommend. And today is such a special day because we're wrapping up season one of The Sopranos with episode 12 and 13. And I've heard a lot of hype around these episodes, so I'm really excited to jump in and see what happens. I'm curious to see who is wearing the wire. I think it's Jimmy. It could be Big P, but I think it's Jimmy. They were both acting kind of sus. And also, what's going on between Junior and Tony? Like, I can't believe in the mafia, people are so easy to like turn on your family and just want them, you know, dead. And all of this is instigated by Livia, who is Tony's own mom. I don't know, that's just kind of like, it's a lot to think about. So much has happened in this season so far. With each episode, they show us more of the characters, their personalities, their fears, their triggers, their motivations, and we get to see more and more the inner workings of this family or this business. And I hope these two episodes just push us deeper into their world. I wanna see how the cookie crumbles. Episode 12 is titled Isabella and episode 13 is titled I Dream of Jeannie Cusimano. And we know Cus is the doctor and I don't know if Jeannie is maybe his wife. No guessing, just enjoying, gonna jump in. I got my hydration station that looks a little different today because I finally washed my other one. Don't judge me. And my headphones fully charged. And let's watch. Got yourself a gun. Who died? Who's this lady?
How many of these things we gotta go to? Brenda Falone's mother at the kid's funeral, the way she carried on.
Fucking manners.
Just want you to know, I always thought you had that right too. You know?
Jimmy, let me tell you something. Don't worry about what I know.
What did that mean?
But he's sleeping all the time. He's not taking care of himself.
A lot of top guys had dark moods. And Napoleon, he was a moody fuck too.
I think he is depressed.
I told Liliana to put some jam bolt in the microwave for you when you get up.
My best friend, Pussy, has disappeared. He's probably fucking dead, okay?
He's disappeared?
If you want me, I will be at the Paramus Mall. Getting your son a suit.
Where is Pussy?
Sunlight is good for people, Tony. In Alaska, they wear these little light hats in the winter so they don't get depressed.
Light hats.
In bed for a week now.
Who is that? New neighbor? I feel like I haven't seen her before. Have we? Is she Jeannie Cusimano?
Can't you? Yeah.
I love the mood that this song is adding to this right now. It's like somber. He's so sad.
It's happening tomorrow.
Good.
Yeah. Black guys. It'll never lead back.
Gave me my first hand job. Me and Vincent Maniscalco in the alley behind the chicken market.
It's going down on a newsstand that he goes to by the medical center.
Where he spills his guts in some fucking shrink's carpet.
He's not gonna suffer. He's gonna have an open casket.
Enough. I don't want to hear any more.
Wow. See, this is what I'm talking about.
Mr. Tony, let me take that rope and wash it for you.
Do I ask you to take the rope?
Rude. How about no, thank you?
Don't do nothing about Jimmy. I don't even know if he's the guy that flipped. I don't know nothing no more.
He's doubting everything. It must be really hard.
How many times do I gotta say it?
I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Going downstairs.
What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna get my pants out of the fucking dryer, okay?
Is he like keeping an eye on him? It's nice. He looks terrible. He has bags under his eyes.
Thought the Cusimanos were away.
Yeah, they went in Bermuda to play golf.
Oh.
I'm a student. I'm here as a part of an exchange program between our two countries.
Well, if my dentist looked like you, I'd stay awake doing a root canal.
Thank you for bringing me... Come si dice, biancheria? I don't know how to say in English.
Well, that makes two of us.
I don't know how to say that in English. Is it like a slip? Is it like, does it a shirt? Is it like pajamas maybe? I think it's pajamas. Shirt. Can you say shirt, lady? Biancheria.
That's him.
Here's where they do it.
Remember, they don't want nothing above the neck.
The newspaper stand. Oh, dang. Yes. Yes, Christopher.
Could you pull forward so we can get out?
Yeah, give me a minute.
Police department.
Where's your badge?
Man, I said move this piece of shit fucking now.
Get the fuck out of my face.
Why?
Be looking straight at us, for Christ's sakes. What are you, fucking Ray Charles?
Jesus Christ, how the hell could it not have gone down?
I know, Junior. I'm sorry.
I wanted it to be over.
I know.
Can't believe Junior. He's the worst.
They'll do it fucking tomorrow, my personal guarantee.
They don't. Some hikers are gonna find your personal guarantee rolled up in a tube and shoved up your ass, you understand?
I hear Tony S's his own mother once unpopped.
Who the fuck told you that?
I don't know. It's just a joke, right?
You think that's funny? A guy's own mother?
It's true. It's true, his own mother. How did he know that?
No, he's okay.
I don't like it. Next, he'd be making jokes about me.
Everyone is. You're an idiot.
Donnie! Sorry!
What the heck? He looks even, like, satisfied. Look at him.
We're trying to give a jolt to your system. Give it a little kickstart.
Why don't you kick me in the fucking head?
Where you go?
I don't feel nothing. Nothing. Dead. Empty.
What were you just thinking about then?
It's a gorgeous piece of coos. It's next door to Cusumano's.
So you do feel something.
Don't split hairs with me.
A residential treatment center.
You got any idea what my life would be worth if certain people found out I checked into a laughing academy?
I'm going to push the Prozac to 60 milligrams.
Sure, why not?
I feel bad for him. That's depression. He looks depressed. He feels depressed.
Look who's here.
I was just talking about you. No kidding. Come on. What's your name?
Isabella.
I'm Tony.
Okay, so the episode is about her. Or named after her.
And where are you people from? Don't tell me. Avellino?
How'd you know that?
I didn't. I guess so. He came after the earthquake.
I love how you say that. Earthquake.
You were making a joke.
No, I'm sorry.
He's infatuated.
But from the 17th century, it's still there, a beautiful palazzo, Palazzo della Donna. And there is a place in the corner of della piazza.
I could hear her talk for hours, actually.
You can smell the blossom from the lemon tree.
What else, Isabella?
È un posto pacifico e tranquillo, dove il tempo sembra essersi fermato. Anche la vita va avanti lentamente, non come le grandi città.
Tu sei l'amore di mamma, vero Antonio?
Oh, she looked at the camera. Broke the fourth wall. Oh, it was like a daydream.
Tony?
Yeah, that would make sense.
I was interested mainly in tumors of the gum and the soft tissue of the mouth.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's very niche interest.
Anthony, what does a gentleman do for a lady?
In his own house?
Well, then.
okay?
Rude.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, look who's decided to join us. And with that breath.
You know, I really don't need that right now, Ma.
Oh, aren't we being sensitive? So some woman in Pennsylvania, she shot her three children and set her house on fire. How come my son's in a bathrobe? Is he sick?
He's fine.
What's he got to be depressed about? Nobody...
I can't listen to Olivia anymore.
Yeah, I suppose it would be better if I never opened my mouth.
It's true.
Oh, I mean, this is really the last time. I am never coming back to this house.
That'd be great for all of us. Can't stand you, Olivia. I'm sorry to everyone who likes her. I don't.
What you looking at?
Oh, nothing.
Who's she?
Dental student. From Italy.
Say, I don't know.
You know her?
Say, I don't know.
We had lunch.
Why are you telling her that?
Going out to dinner with you is a distant memory from
Agreed.
Me. You have time to take her to lunch?
Can't get out of bed and you take her to lunch?
All it takes is a half inch of another woman's thigh to get your ass out of bed? What am I, a fucking idiot? If I had an ounce of self-respect, I would cut your dick off.
I'm with you, Carmella. I really am.
My cousin Keke, after he had his lobotomy, looked exactly like my son.
Olivia.
Empty. A shell.
Lobotomy?
I don't want to hear about her anymore. Don't talk about Tony. It's done.
I wonder what the element of the wind in this episode. So random. Oh, man. I love the music here. Oh my God. I'm sorry, his survival instincts are... Wow, I can't believe he survived that. He just... Oh yeah, this is what does it.
Daddy, where is he? Please let him be alright. They almost killed you for a stupid car.
I guess nobody told him about the kind of gas mileage that thing gets, I bet.
It's not funny, Dad.
Christ.
You
people can't wait till they finish all my ear back on?
We're offering your husband full immunity from prosecution in return for any testimony that he might give us. We'll relocate you and your family. You'll be completely safe in case you change your mind.
I took an oath, Carmella.
What are you, a kid in a treehouse?
You want to move to Utah? Be Mr. and Mrs. Mike Smith? We can sell some Indian relics by the road. Maybe start a rattlesnake ranch.
This is our chance to get out, Tony.
I would do it. I would take it. I mean, I think it's a great, great deal. These two.
Hey, it's Uncle Sully and Uncle Paul.
Ride or dies.
Take more than it. You're making bobsled team with cap guns to stop your old man. Where is he?
Por qué? Is it because there are two of them? Bobsled team? The references in this show is, they're hilarious.
Soprano escaped with minor wounds and was taken to an undisclosed area hospital. However, one of his assailants, William Johnson Petit Claiborne, was fatally wounded.
How could this happen?
I don't know. I don't figure no.
You know.
My son got shot and he got away.
What do we do now? What the fuck do we do now, Olivia?
We go see him. She's my only son.
Some fucking shit, huh? Tony.
I love Christopher. Every time I see him, it just makes me happy.
The live one took off in a Taurus. Taurus? These guys I had a beef with at the newsstand.
You were there?
Not yesterday, the day before. No Don't worry, Mom. All right, come on.
Your ear, it's disfigured.
Come
on. Your ear is disfigured.
Look who it is. Father Intintola.
He's back.
My name is a friend.
Why don't you grab a sandwich and we'll talk later? I mean, you're sleeping over, right?
Yes.
Did you ever tell anybody about you and me?
I may have mentioned something to my immediate family that I had a patient who was in some trouble with all the stuff we were hearing about in the news. Does your family know?
My mother's made a few comments, but I don't see how she knows. Hey, don't even go there about the old lady.
She's orchestrating everything, Tony. How can you not tell?
How are you doing with all of this?
To tell the truth, I feel pretty good.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Talk about a jolt to the system. Try getting shot at. It'll give you a nice kick start. I had lunch with that girl next door, you know?
You did?
Isabella. Anyway, she was talking and we went to another place, like, in my mind's eye.
Hmm.
And she had this baby. She was holding it, you know, at her breast. She was nursing it. She was whispering to it, like, it's okay, little baby. Don't cry. She was calling Antonio.
Anthony, your fantasy, that's you, that little baby.
Kiss your mom? That's quick 5-minute session. How much do you think she charges for a 5-minute car session?
What was that bullshit yesterday? You don't even recognize your granddaughter?
Well, I...
Is she gonna start to pretend to be forgetting things so that in case it all goes back to them?
It's terrific timing.
She's like...
Right after the move on your son goes in the toilet.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Olivia, you manipulative bitch. She's totally doing that. I didn't think any of it yet, like yesterday when they were in the house, but like, I think he's right. I think.
Jeannie, she wrecked up a motorbike. She hurt her ankle pretty bad.
Oh, genius.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
The wife.
Thanks.
So where's your dental student? You don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, do you?
I don't, I got no idea what you're talking about.
What?
You didn't have an Italian girl. She's here studying the...
We had Skippy Palumbo from down the street come into the house to take care of the dog.
Frankly, I think I've said enough about it. I never threatened to cut your dick off.
Carmela looks great. She's got a body on her. What, did he imagine her? Did that whole thing was...
There was no Isabella. I just talked to Cusimano.
Discontinue the lithium.
I already flushed it.
Even if it was the medicine?
This fantasy of yours has meaning.
Mm.
You know, the issue of mother and child. Your mother is always talking about infanticide.
Yeah, it's a sad situation that goes on in the world.
Yeah.
Are you still feeling okay?
Remember? Remember when she talked about the mom who killed her kids, and also she would rather, you know, kill her kids than go to Reno. And also she's talking about the people that throw babies out the window in New York in like the first couple episodes. That's true, you're right. She's always talking about infanticide. Melfi, you're good. With the blue moon in your eyes.
Jimmy, this answers your concerns?
I think a lot of good ground was covered.
You're right, it's him.
All of a sudden he asked for a meeting to discuss shit we already covered.
Dang. They just try to kill you. They both just try to kill you, Tony.
How's the hype?
I know they're gonna get it.
I don't know. This is here.
You didn't even let me put anything decent on.
Is Tatiana here?
I'll go get her. You alright, Jimmy?
Yeah, that's right. I'm Jimmy. Big tits, little feet, hitting any man's league.
Oh. How does he not suspect? No.
Fucking punk ass pieces of shit. Would you forget our captain?
Why don't you call for help in your radio mic, you fucking rat?
Lord of God.
And the last thing I need is for your parents to come home and your dad sees my Dominican ass.
Jesus fuck!
Is she acting? Or is she really?
Hey, what do you want, lady?
Go away. I will never speak another word to you again, Satemia.
Grandma, it's Meadow, remember? Come sit down.
Yes.
Evening. How are we tonight?
Make my sister get out of the house.
Why are you walking on Mountain Avenue at this hour?
Shut up.
Shit.
You know this young man?
Where was she trying to get to?
Shrifts.
Should I believe her? Do you believe her? I mean, you already probably know.
Isn't it interesting how this memory loss is cropped up right after you failed to be killed in the carjacking? Right around the time of the shooting, you were having hallucinations of that Isabella figure. Your subconscious was shouting something at you.
She's good.
What do you think? My mother tried to have me whacked because I put her in a nursing home?
Yes.
I say what your mother has, at the very least, is what we call borderline personality disorder.
A borderline personality disorder.
Borderline personalities are very good at splitting behavior, creating bitterness and conflict between others in their circle.
You twisted fucking bitch. See, we're through, you and I. We're finished. And you're lucky if I don't break your fucking face in 50,000 pieces.
Okay. Tony, what the... You should stop seeing him forever.
I mean, let's face it.
Ladies, compliments of the house.
Artie, he got his new restaurant.
The insurance really came through.
Yes, it did.
When are you going to bury the hatchet?
Yeah, Charmaine.
We just don't want this place to become another mob hangout like the old Vesuvio.
Kind of agree.
That kind of buzz, we should avoid in droves.
Charmaine, it's always so annoying. But I kind of agree.
The Della Croce's gave me a gift certificate.
Ugh, I hate this dude.
You will not believe the food.
We had some Zabayon that... Well, now, of course, we did make it together. But everybody was just raving about it.
Please, you made it, basically.
Yeah, how's the watch, Father?
Sorry. It's fantastic. I realized this morning I can set one of the dials to the millennial countdown.
Is that Jackie's watch?
Thanks again, Rob.
Ugh, what a sleaze. What is with him? Always taking food, staying over, taking the watch. Oh. Was that an actual rat in his mouth? Did they find the rat dead or did they kill the rat and then put it in his mouth?
I'm sure Agent Harris explained that there's something we'd like you to hear. You know Agent Grasso, I believe.
Hey, how you doing?
How you doing?
But we do share some cultural ideas. Religious. Culinary.
Well, why don't you get the kumquats out of your mouth and get to the fucking point? Yeah. I don't know what you're talking about.
Stop mealy-mouthing.
Psychiatrist. He's been seeing one for a while now. God only knows what he says.
They bugged.
He must have really taken me.
Green Grove.
It was my idea.
Better Keiki had died than go on living like that. That's what his own mother always used to say.
He feels bad for Tony.
You and my capos have their mothers in this place? If this is true, Livia, you know what I mean, I'm the boss, for Christ's sake. If I don't act, blood or no, I have to.
I feel for him so much right now.
You remember me? Arthur Bucco.
That's right. Victoria's boy.
That's right. But you're right about the Little League. That was me and Tony.
My son. How's your mother? You call her every day.
Mom passed away.
Really?
She probably knows that. She's so manipulative.
Give him my regards. Is she still on that crazy diet?
Okay.
From my restaurant, I don't know if you remember Vesuvio.
Oh, of course I do. Cappuccino.
With the nice duck ragu.
Yum.
What's the matter?
The ice cream truck is going by. I can hear it, but I got wine.
After what my son did to you. Oh, how can I look you in the face?
What did he do now?
You don't blame him for setting the fire?
Livia!
Well, you're a bigger man than some.
Oh, she's so evil.
For that nobody was incinerated to death.
Livia, I can't believe it. She just keeps getting worse and worse. She's so bad. She's bad. This is itching my ears because the hat. But I've had hair.
It's Junior and Mikey that definitely took out the hit. Stop things moving.
Not like we didn't know.
How did you find out for sure?
There's no room for interpretation. If I'm your uncle, I gotta finish what I started. He could strike first.
Yeah, and he won't use boys to mend this.
T, anything else? My ear hurts.
I love T's crew. These three, ride or die babies.
What kind of person can I be where his own mother wants him dead?
Dang.
Problem is not with you.
She's evil. Terrible mother. Terrible person.
Well, I could kill her with these two hands.
You should.
You gotta play the concerned daughter-in-law. You gotta stay even-keeled for the sake of the business.
Fuck the business. Dollars to donuts, this Alzheimer's thing is an act. So she can't be called on a shit.
Yes. Agreed.
Uncle June and I, we had our problems. But I never should have razzed him about eating pussy. This whole world could have been averted.
That's true. That's
Cunnilingus
true.
Cunnilingus and psychiatry brought us to this.
You had...
Cunnilingus and psychiatry brought us to this. What a line.
I'll take care of my uncle. And I'll take care of Mikey P. And I'll get some satisfaction. But inside, I'll know.
It has to be a really lonely place.
Tom.
Jesus Christ, relax. Look at this baby. I caught right off the point here.
You're leaving your prints everywhere, Tone. You're just disappearing him? Then why'd you shoot him 20 million times? You just done one shot, avoid as much blood as you can, and then sink him. I don't know. Why, like, listen to me. Why am I talking like a mobster? Gets on you. How you doing?
Just wait a minute. Wait.
Oh, no.
Wait.
I would react the
I'm
same.
I'm dialing 911. Do I have your word that I'm in no physical danger?
Yes, I am humbled that you would take my word, yes. Hello?
Yeah. No, you won't need it, but I would still bring it with me. I mean, you don't know with Tony. Tony's too erratic.
I take no pleasure in the fact that I was right about your mother.
One of the reasons that they tried to have me clipped is because I'm seeing a shrink. You.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
You're in danger.
Get out of here. That's not fair.
Fair? What are you talking about fair? Oh, God, it's fair. They don't give a shit about fair.
I have a life. I have patience.
Well, you tell them August came early this year.
It doesn't work that way.
I know. I'm sorry, okay?
Yeah.
I'm going to work on this problem with the people that pose a threat to you, and I'll take care of it, and you'll be able to come back.
People are going to get murdered, aren't they?
Don't worry about those distractions. You keep your eye on the ball. You've been a good doctor to me. Thank you.
Okay. I would set her up. Like, I would just buy her a ticket, pay for her hotel. I mean, it's all your fault.
What the fuck are you doing?
How could you?
How the fuck could you?
You took their money?
That restaurant was like my child.
Three generations of Buco sweated over that same stove. Don't say she's lying, Tone, because why would she? What'd she tell you, my mother?
He's finding out.
Don't make it worse. Do me the respect of not treating me like a fucking idiot, piece of shit.
Tell him Junior is gonna kill someone.
Why the fuck would I blow up your restaurant?
To help me! You hear your uncle's gonna hurt my business by staging a hit in my place, and that's your solution? What kind of stupid, sick, twisted logic?
I mean, he was kind of trying to get you out of town, remember? Cruz?
My mother is going senile, Artie.
I love my new place so much, and this ruins everything!
I swear, my mother.
Guess your mother means nothing to you now because she wants you dead. She's worthless to you, and that's why you can use her name like that.
Take it easy. What the fuck are you doing?
Stop it, Artie. You're not this person. You're gentle and normal.
You know, I read last week in the paper about this family in St. Louis Obispo. That whole family died of trichinosis. That's uncooked pork.
Oh, I wanted that tension to like come to a head. I wanted someone to say something.
I'm full of rage, Father. Murderous. Whatever. Urges.
Oh, Arnie, what?
Have you talked with your wife? I can't.
Why?
What it would do to her. I mean, what if I'm wrong? I could get hit with a defamation suit.
Arthur, you know what your heart is telling you. The only reason you haven't told Charmaine is because you know she'll insist you go to the police immediately.
Yeah.
And this will jeopardize your restaurant.
I think you should just leave it, Artie.
I need to tell you something. And I want you should hear it from me, not from some asshole on the street. About 4 or 5 months ago, I started seeing a psychiatrist. You know, I was passing out, and she's been helping me with that.
Well, I'm sure you did it with complete discretion.
Nice.
It's not the worst thing I ever heard. I was seeing a therapist myself about a year ago.
Nice. Okay, nice. Cool.
Be better if we could admit to each other these are painful.
Yeah.
Stressful times.
Yeah.
It was like marriage counseling. Yeah, like that.
This meeting has told us a lot about these characters and their dynamics.
Which did you check on?
The fresh basil, really.
Wait, are you jealous? Or are you just realizing that this is who he is? Don't throw it. It's no, don't, please. Oh my god, please don't. I will. I would have paid for that.
At my other job, the waiters usually do the cocktail solicitation.
Adriana.
But if you want, I'll do it as I seat them.
As a hostess, new hostess.
She catches on fast, that one. She's working two jobs to become a music manager.
Oh, nice.
Whatever that is.
She's pursuing that.
I feel so wonderful. We're Charmaine up and running
looks
again.
Happy.
Oh, you said you had something to tell me.
I like the bar stools.
Nice. Good job, Artie. Because Charmaine looks so happy.
And if Chucky calls, you get me on the cell phone. Ho! You hear me?
Ooh. Rude.
Okay, I think that I heard you already.
Go take a Midol.
Go take a Midol.
Nips! Nips! Bad boy.
Relatable. I hope Christopher does it, because I feel like them two are kind of in the same rank, although I feel like Mikey is higher up now, but before they were kind of in the same rank. And Mikey nipped Brendan, who was besties with Chris. I can't believe I remember all of this. It's interesting, by the way, that there's no music here.
Motherfucker! Fucking poison ivy all over.
My friend Brendan, you shot him in his bathtub naked. No chance to run. I swear to God.
You fuck, Poseidus.
I can feel it itching me already.
I mean, I knew they were gonna do it, but that was kind of like.
Corrado Soprano, FBI.
Fuck.
Fuck.
Are you Lawrence Parisi? Joseph Sasso, you're under arrest.
Junior Soprano, alleged boss of the New Jersey crime family that bears his name, was indicted today on federal racketeering charges.
Look at the old guy, making him do the perp walk. A legitimate businessman.
Dad, cut the crap.
Go blow dry your hair.
He told me that he loved me and that he would be right back.
To take my doll, he said.
I wasn't named because the focus of the investigation is some telephone calling card scam that Junior and Larry had going and this Diamante technical stock thing that I wasn't into.
You're lucky. You're lucky, Tony.
What I gotta worry about now is the guys that got pinched today, if they flip.
He should just take the offer and leave to the witness protection program or whatever.
But you also said the sun was unstable. I was angry. A little too comfortable outside the law. Yes, he is. But it would only add to the quotient of sorrow in the world to doubt him.
Your tenure as boss was a short one. Actually, it was unusual in several ways.
They're gonna tap into his insecurities.
You were not the boss of North Jersey, and in fact, your nephew, Anthony Soprano, was and is. We want Johnny Sack. But more than him, Johnny, we want Mangano and Teresi.
I want to fuck Angie Dickinson. See who gets lucky first.
You're 70 years old. How many years you got left?
My nephew running things? Not in this life.
Wow. I think his ego is so big that he'd rather just go to jail. Look at this guy in the fridge.
I mean, it's practically a cocktail hour anyway.
Mm-mm. Would you rather have a glass of wine?
How about a little A? You in the mood?
Just came to check on you guys. See how you're holding up with these indictments.
These two make me uncomfortable, you know that.
Told her she was not to use my card again.
No, that's mine. One True Thing, just out on DVD. My real concern for Tony.
Father, he doesn't give a flying fuck. And you come up here and you eat his steaks. And you use his home entertainment center.
You do think I'm a schnorrer, don't you? A parasite.
Yes.
I think that you like the, I don't even know what to call it, the
attention?
Whiff of sexuality.
Oh.
That never goes anyplace. Call this an intervention.
Nice.
Think you have this MO where you manipulate spiritually thirsty women? And I think a lot of it is tied up with food somehow, as well as the sexual tension game.
Yes. You just summarized everything. Look at him. He can't take it.
Whoa.
Yeah. Someone put it into words. You need to see Dr. Melfi, Father. Are you missing one at home?
Your mom's had a stroke.
Stroke?
The news on TV yesterday, it really upset her. Not that it's any of my business. Anyhow, it just happened. The MTs are...
He smiles.
I know what you did.
Sir, please.
The only son. Your middle child.
Uncle June's in jail now. And I got one more little last detail I gotta take care of.
I'm gonna live a nice, long, happy life, which is more than I can say for you.
All right, that's enough!
She doesn't understand you.
She's smiling! Look at the look on her face! Look at the look on her face! She's smiling!
Come on!
Come off me! Come off me! Look at her face!
Wow. Wow, this whole scene was so strong.
She got vacation.
Like he told her to. I mean, he kind of pressured her into.
I think it's Walnut Parkway.
got an idea.
Arnie, thank Christ.
We can't get to the house. There's a huge tree across Mount Avenue.
Nobody's eating nothing.
Tone, I got no power, no lights. I'm closing soon as these last few people leave.
Go to Mickey D's. They'll be open.
Yeah, I always go to Mickey D's.
Come on. What are you... Come on.
Get it.
We'll figure out something. Come on.
They gave me steroids too, but it fucked me up.
Look. Yeah, well, look at Pauly. Look at Pauly.
He's going to be the new boss now. In name and everything. Wish him buona fortuna.
Nice. That's sweet.
Oh, God, Artie, you saved our friggin' lives here.
It's beautiful, Artie. Thank you. Enjoy.
Yum.
Someday soon, you're gonna have families of your own. And if you're lucky, you remember the little moments. Like this. That were good. Cheers.
Oh, that's sweet. Wow, I have so many thoughts. I love how they wrapped everything up. Everything. Let's unpack. Okay, let's start this breakdown with Isabella. Beautiful, goddess, gorgeous. And I actually thought that Tony was gonna have a little like love interest or a love affair with her, and he didn't, because she doesn't exist. So Tony's now hallucinating, but most importantly, he's longing for this sweet and nurturing and understanding mother figure that he never had. And even growing up, when we saw that episode when he was little, even growing up, she was rough, and she was the Livia that she is now, but raising these kids. And I'm actually really shocked at how like blood family are so easy to just like want a family member killed. Like Livia is orchestrating this whole thing, and also Junior ordered a hit on Tony. I think he took it too far. I'm really impressed that Tony's survival instincts kicked in, and it actually showed him that he has the will to live. He had told Dr. Amalfi that he felt numb and empty and that he was really depressed. And I think this attempt to get him jolted him out of that depression and showed him that he actually does want to live. So good for him. I just hate that he had to almost get killed to get it. When he survived this attempt, Livia started acting a little demented, like she forgot who Meadow is. And I think, and I also, Junior thinks and Carmela thinks that she's faking this so that it never gets back to her. Or if it does get back to her, she can play dumb, like she's has Alzheimer's. Which is so bad. Like, it really shows how evil of a person she is and how shit of a mom she is. Gosh, I'm getting heated here. She also tells Artie that Tony blew up his restaurant. She's just stirring shit up. Speaking of Artie, I'm actually glad that they brought this story back, like the storyline. By the way, I feel like these two last episodes that we just watched did a great job in wrapping everything up for us. All the storylines that kind of died off throughout the season, they made sure to bring it back and close the loop there. Like they did with Artie's restaurant. That happened in the first or second episode, and I thought it would die off there, but they brought it back. They told us he opened a second restaurant. They showed us Charmaine and happy with her new restaurant, etc. And they also did that with Father Phil. Carmela called him out for being a freeloader and made me really, really happy. You guys know how I feel about Father Phil. So seeing her kind of take action and just shut him out like that, great. Good for you, Carmela. I really love that the FBI is now involving Tony and offering him to be in the witness protection program and trying to convince him by showing him the tapes in which Livia and Junior are talking about all of this and convincing him that they're behind his attempt to murder attempt. But he won't budge. He says no. He says don't talk to Carmela. Don't leave us alone. Good for you, Tony. Anyway, later we see Junior and other mobsters, like 13 other people, maybe 15, a bunch of them, get arrested for charges involving a business that Tony's not part of. So they got everyone but Tony and his crew. and they try to get Junior to confess that Tony's actually running the show and Junior's just another pawn, but he doesn't. He doesn't say anything about it. And you can tell how big his ego is, that he would rather go down than say that he's just a pawn on his nephew's show. He'd rather kill his nephew than admit that his nephew's actually the boss. And again, we see his ego and his insecurities kind of dictate his actions. But I think the most powerful scene in these two episodes is when Tony shows up to the hospital and grabs the pillow and goes to try to take care of Livia, but she's being wheeled away because she had a stroke. And for a second, I thought that Tony was gonna be concerned for her and kind of like regret wanting to asphyxiate her or whatever, and, you know, be there for her. But instead, he accused her there in front of everyone, the doctors, the nurses, everyone, that she's orchestrating everything. And the episode kind of ends there, but not, I mean, ends on that note, but not really, because then we realized that Melfi went on vacation. Good for you, Melfi. And then also they had like a little moment. It was actually a really heartfelt moment in that restaurant in the Nuovo Vesuvio. Loved that name. Artie's restaurant where he does like a little toast for his family and talks about appreciating the little moments. But in general, I think the scene where Tony is accusing Livia and she's being wheeled away, I think that was so incredible. Thank you all for watching with me. I loved these two episodes and I'm actually so pumped to start season two because I heard it gets better. So I'm gonna jump right in. Make sure you like this video if you liked it. Make sure you comment. Make sure you share with your friends and go follow me on Instagram @ChristyReacts. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.